Are you struggling with how to fully transition to a plant-based diet? Well, stay tuned. I'm going to share exactly how you can use cream corn and make some delicious meals from it. Hey, in case you don't know me, my name is Jason Chaney, and this is one of the questions I had got in. What can I do with some vegan cream corn? Like, I don't know what to do with it. And it's really fun because there's so many things you can do with it. This is what I love about being plant-based, is because there's nothing that I can't eat. So one of the things that you want to do, depending on your ethnic background, your cultural background, and things like that, and where you're from demographically, is you want to start seeing what meals do you use in your region that use that. So, like, if you're Latin, because I'm in South America right now, one of the things they have is like, it's called, in Panama it's called chichimi, and here in Colombia I think they call it mazamora. It's a cream corn like soupy dish. They eat it for breakfast. Depending on which region you're in, sometimes it's sweeter, sometimes it's spicier, sometimes a little more sour. But that's one of the things you can do if that's in your wheelhouse, if you have a Latin background. If not, let's say if you're from like the East Coast, New England, or something like that, you can do like a corn chowder. You can do your play on a clam chowder, and you can do it with the cream corn. So you can do a corn chowder, and if you want like the clam bites and stuff like that, you can use different types of mushrooms. One of the best mushrooms that you can use with it is oyster mushrooms, and you just cut them to look like little scallops, and they have a very good texture when they break down inside the chowder, like in the chowder or the soup. If you're from the South like me, you have a ton of options. You may want to do a cream corn cornbread. I like to do a cream corn cornbread with jalapenos in it. I'm a spicy person. You can also do corn fritters. Yes, you heard me right. You can do corn fritters. Take the cream corn, form them into little balls, or you can put them in an ice tray or something like that, and put them in the freezer so they'll get solid. After they get solid, just make a little vegan batter. You can use chickpea flour, regular flour, whatever type of flour you want. And you can batter them up and then air fry them and turn them into cream corn fritters, which is delicious, by the way. So like, there's tons of things you can do with it. Let's say if you're from the islands, like my wife Cece, her family's from the islands. You can make spoony cornbread. If you're not familiar with what that is, it's like a cornbread, but it has the cream corn in it. It's like really, really delicious. Really delicious meal. Like, there's tons of things that you can do. You can do soups, you can do salads, you can mix it with quinoa. Like, don't feel like I have this cream corn, all I can do is just warm it up on the stove. Be creative with it. Don't be afraid to try new things. You can make a cream corn pudding, things like that. So like, this just shows you with one ingredient, such as vegan cream corn, you can make all these different meals. And we're talking about across borders, across ethnicities, across cultural lines. And just think about that. What can you do with other foods, such as potatoes, rice, beans, different greens, carrots, lasagna, spaghettis? Like, you can make as many meals as you want, but don't let lack of creativity be the thing that stop you from being able to thrive on a plant-based diet. So I hope that was helpful for you. I hope you like this. If you like this type of information, let me know. Just hit a like button on there. But also, if you're struggling and you're thinking about, okay, what are some ways that I can start eating healthier? What are some ways I can just start saving a little bit of money while I'm eating healthier? Well, that's why I put all this together. That's why I also have a free Facebook group together where it's showing you how to thrive on a plant-based diet. It's showing you how you can be healthy without breaking the bank. It's time for us to stop the myth of, oh, it's too expensive to be healthy. Because right now, it's too expensive not to be healthy. We're spending so much money on shit that is not helping us be healthy that we have to cut it out. And we have to not only get our health back, we have to get our money back also. So if you're someone that really want to start getting your health back and you want to start saving some money at the same time, just click the link up above, join the free webinar. It will be tomorrow. In this webinar, I'm going to go through the three myths that the diet industry is keeping from us. And in these myths is where I break down exactly why most people are having a hard time losing weight. And it was the exact same reason why I was having a hard time also. And it ended up getting me to 550 plus pounds. Until I understood these three myths around dieting, this is why I was always stuck. I was in that hamster wheel, just running back and forth, back and forth. I would lose a little bit of weight, gain back a hell of a lot more. And I want to stop people from having to feel that pain in that hamster wheel. So if you want to hop on the free webinar, just click the link up above. I will see you there tomorrow, and have a great day and stay supercharged.